श्री प्रद्युत बारदोलाई जी, प्रद्युत जी।
थैंक यू सर। In fact, as I stand here to speak on the climate change issue, I would like to appreciate and endorse your opening remark that this discussion on climate change cannot be partisan. Let it be human one, because for trying to have clean air, water, and a livable climate, in fact, are the inalienable human right. But of course, one is perturbed to note that at times the government is behaving in a very indifferent manner, it seems, when it comes to the urgency of the ill effects of climate change. The government is growing thick-skinned. So the climate change is real, and it's very tangible today in India. I would not just like to quote the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change report records that there has been a very progressive increase in the extreme weather conditions in India in the last decade. And everybody knows that northeastern region of the country has the highest tree cover, the forest cover. But unfortunately, in the report, NER also witnessing alterations in rainfall pattern. In fact, in the last 50 years, erratic and untimely rainfall has caused havoc in the northeastern region. The northeastern region is the storehouse of biodiversity. It harbors the mega hotspots of forestry, rainforest, and the biodiversity. Unfortunately, the climate change has taken its toll. There is a new concept, new description of climate refugees. In Assam, we have been seeing the plight of the climate refugees, because the people who live in the riverine areas, who take shelter in the river islands, are routinely get homeless because of the fluctuations of the river water flow and the erratic floods pattern. As a result, these climate refugees get homeless. They try to find new space for them. At times, they surreptitiously go and take shelter in the reserve forest and grazing land, where the government again target them and evict them ruthlessly. So the climate change also has given various other dimensions that government should take care of. So at a time when northeastern region is the storehouse of biodiversity, for inexplicable reason, the government is trying to implement the oil palm mission, especially in the northeast and Andaman and Nicobar Island. This is something cannot be acceptable, because we all know that palm oil cultivation, what difficulties they have caused in countries like Indonesia and Malaysia. There are case studies. There has been case studies, and it has been shown that palm oil cultivation has really created a very difficult climatic condition in Indonesia and Malaysia. So much so that Sri Lanka has decided to uproot the existing palm oil cultivation. At a time like that, we don't understand why government of India is trying to target the northeastern region and Andaman and Nicobar Island, where the highest forest cover we have, where the biodiversity is well known. But at a time, the government of India is trying to target northeastern region, and that should be avoided. So the University of Maryland's Global Forest Watch report revealed that northeastern region saw the highest loss of forest cover in India, accounting for 76% loss of India's forest cover in last 20 years. This is an alarming figure. And unfortunately, my home state accounts for 14.1% of India's total tree cover loss alone in last 7 years. So at this time, I think we have to be very careful, and we have the last remnants of rainforest in a particular districts of Upper Assam, namely Tinsukia district. It is very unfortunate that those areas bordering Myanmar, up to Hukwang Valley of Myanmar, we have, you know, the last remnants of rainforest. But in those rainforests, when earlier government was trying to protect them, but now the new mafia, new coal mafia has emerged. They have started the rat hole coal mining. They are trying, they are doing the degradation. They are uprooting the reserve forest. They are uprooting the wildlife sanctuaries. And obviously, in collaboration, in connivance with the police and district officials. At a tight time like that, the government should take very stern measures to arrest this kind of degradation of rainforest. So at a time when we are talking about forest cover, at a time when we are talking about climate change, it is very unfortunate that government is also trying to talk about new amendments of the Forest Conservation Act 1980. If Forest Conservation Act 1980 is slackened and further liberalization is done, then probably the reserve forest we have, that will further degrade it. And government should be very careful. And at a time when the world community is getting together at the Glasgow Convention, the role of the government would be very necessary. So at a time when the entire world community is uniting to arrest further growth of coal-fired power plants and fossil-fired uses, this time the government of India has not given its final commitment, because India has abstained from signing the COP26. And the global methane pledge towards reducing methane emissions has been very carefully avoided by the government of India. That should not be there. Government of India should rise above all kind of sectarian interest and should unite with the world community to fight the climate change. So India has taken a very self-defeating posture in Glasgow Declaration on Forest and Land Use. I want to say the clear and present danger of climate change is this, that we cannot burn our future for the present day prosperity. This should be very important for all of us. And I want to tell you that there should not be any kind of sectarian attitude. And remember, we are the first generation to feel the sting of climate change. And probably we are the last generation that can arrest the further deterioration of climate change. And we must arrest the further deterioration of climate change. And let's do it. Thank you, sir.
माननीय सदस्यगण, जलवायु परिवर्तन जैसे गंभीर विषय पर सदन में सभी पक्षों के सभी माननीय सदस्यों की सक्रिय भागीदारी से ये चर्चा अत्यंत सार्थक हो रही है। विषय की व्यापकता तथा माननीय सदस्यों की सहभागिता को देखते हुए इस महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर चर्चा आगे भी जारी रहेगी। सभा की बैठक कल शुक्रवार दिनांक 9 दिसंबर 2000 कल गुरुवार 9 दिसंबर 2021 को प्रोन 11 बजे तक के लिए स्थगित की जाती है।